Today's video is a request from Tina Martins, who wanted to know how to make Gothic arch templates for the Cricut. The great thing about these is that you can also use the same template files for laser cutters, or just print them out and cut them by hand. You can even import them in Blender and use them as the basis for a 3D model for printing, if that's your jam. We're going to be using Inkscape, which is a free vector graphics package you can find at inkscape.org. Just hit download now and pick whichever version you need. Once you have installed it, you can go ahead and open it. I'm going to start by pulling down a guide and drawing a circle. You can use Ctrl and Shift to constrain it, but don't worry, you can change the radius later. When the circle is done, make sure it's selected and go to the Path menu and select Object to Path. Then go ahead and copy and paste the circle to make another one. Now we want the circles to touch at the centers, and to make that easier, we're going to switch on snapping on the right here. Make sure both circles are selected. Select Intersection from the Path menu, and we'll be left with the parts of the circles which overlap. Now we add a rectangle, change it to a path, and snap it in place. Select everything and pick Union from the Path menu. That's our first shape. Next, make a couple of copies. I'm changing the color of this one so we can see what we're doing. Click the lock icon up here to retain the aspect ratio and change the width to something smaller. Drop the smaller piece in place. You can nudge it in place by using the arrow keys. When it's in place, select both shapes by holding down Shift and clicking them, and pick Difference from the Path menu. This makes a cutout in the shape. Next, make a couple of copies of the new shape and nudge them so that one side overlaps. Make a copy of the first shape and drop it in the middle. Join the two hollow shapes with Union, then use Intersection on the two new shapes. That gives us the central piece but loses the arch, so make a copy of the hollow shape, drop it back in place, and union it with the Y shape. Now let's say we want one without the opening at the top. Make a copy, draw a path in there, and union it into the next shape. Next, we want a cutout shape which will be visible through the top window. We're going to make a couple of copies and change the one with the window to red, so we can see what we're doing. If the one with the window ends up behind the other one, you can use Send to Back to put the other one behind it. We can now draw stuff in here and use Difference to make a cutout, and we can be sure it will be visible through the window. Then we can just delete the window we used as a guide. When you're done drawing, we can select everything, set a stroke paint, and remove the fill paint. Save the file as an SVG, and it's ready to go to the cutter. You can also import the drawing in Blender and use it to build a model from, if that's your kind of thing. Hope that was useful. If you want more crafting videos, check out this playlist. Bye!